Okay, so in this video, let's do the task 3 for digital cameras. And there are 15 marks available for this task, and you should check all of your work as you go along. Let me introduce this task to you. So, introduction, the task is about testing digital cameras. You asked testers to give a score to 4 digital cameras for 3 features. Now, you will be asking them about picture quality, how long the batteries last, and how easy it is to use. Now, these are the scores for how easy it is to use. So you got 4 cameras, Hex 11, Apollo SX, Cam XL and Japa C4. And then again, if you take a look at it, you got different number of testers giving different scores for the 4 cameras. So what is average? Now, average is a common number, or it's a common number for all of the given scores. Okay, so an average for how easy it is to use for Hex 11 given by 15 testers would be the sum of all the scores given by the testers divided by the number of testers. So let us write a formula: mean score or average is total scores divided by the number of testers. So now the total score would be 5 plus 7 plus 4 plus 8 plus 5 plus 7 plus 6 plus 5 plus 7 plus 8 plus 6 plus 4 plus 10 plus 10 plus 7, and this total divided by total number of testers, which is 15. So now I'm going to use my friend here, Mr. Calculator. So I'm going to do the total now. That's 5 plus 7 plus 4 plus 8 plus 5 plus 7 plus 6 plus 5 plus 7 plus 8 plus 6 plus 4 plus 10 plus 10 plus 7, which will be equal to 99. So that's going to be equal to 99 divided by 15, which will be equal to, that's my answer divided by 15 will be equal to 33 divided by 5, and in a decimal form it is going to be 6.6. so that is my mean for the Hex 11, 6.6. now I'm going to use the same technique to find the average for rest of the camera. So this one was for Hex 11, so I'm going to write here Hex 11. The next one would be Apollo SX. That is going to be the total over here. So I'm going to just directly enter the numbers in here, because you don't need to show the working out for all of the cameras. It's going to be messy. So I'm going to find out the total. So that is going to be 8 plus 9 plus 9 plus 7 plus 7 plus 9 plus 6 plus 8 plus 7 plus 8 plus 8 plus 10. Total is 96 divided by 12, which is my total number of testers, and my answer is 8. And then same thing for Cam XL. Cam XL will be equal to, so I'm going to make a note of it over here, 8, which is also equal to 96 over 12. Cam XL is, again, 6 plus 8 plus 6 plus 5 plus 7 plus 5 plus 6 plus 4 plus 8 plus 7, total is 62, divided by Cam XL 10. So the mean is 6.2. Then you got JAPA 66C4, JAPA C4, which will be equal to, now the total I'm going to do again, 5 plus 7 plus 2 plus 7 plus 3 plus 6 plus 5 plus 5 plus 8 plus 5 plus 2 plus 5, total is 60, divided by 12, which will be equal to, divided by 12 will be equal to 5. So JAPA 4 is 5, CAM XL is 6.2. So this is the task 3A solved. Now let's move on to task 3B. So what does task 3B say? Choose one of your calculations in 3A to show a check. Check it by a different method to the one you used originally. You can put an approximation, a reverse calculation, or any other suitable different method. Write your check here. So what you need to do is, again, you need to calculate the average using a different method. Now what we did to find average, we added all of the sums in all of the numbers in total and divided it by the number of testers there were. All of the scores in total divided by the number of testers there were. Another method to find an average, you know, directly, is to take a look at all of the data and find out which is the highest number of occurrence of a number. For example, what I'm going to do is I'm going to work out with Apollo SX. Now here it has a total of 12 scores. Now I'm going to look at which number occurs the most. So I got 8 here, once, twice, thrice, and 4 times. 9 occurs 1, 2, thrice. 7 occurs again thrice, and 6 occurs once, and 10 occurs once. So my most occurring number over here is 8. So hence I am going to write a approximation to find average score for Apollo SX is 8, because since 8 occurs the most times. So that is my this is an approximate method that you can use to find the average. Again, just look at the data and see which number occurs the most, and there is a good chance that your average. So for this section 3C, it says draw a chart to show the means for how easy it is to use the four cameras. The most obvious way I can think of to draw a chart over here is a bar graph. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to assign a scale first of all for the mean values that I have. Now I'm going to show you the mean values that I have calculated over here in my previous paper. Okay, and I'm going to draw them accordingly. That's the mean score. Let me make a note of the mean score actually on this section. So hex 11 was, I don't need a calculator, 6.6. Apollo APO Apollo SX was 8. CAM XL was 6.2. JAPA C4 was 5. So I've got my scores noted over here, which I'll need. Now, before drawing a bar graph, you always assign a scale. So what I'm going to do is, what I mean by scale is, 1 centimeter on my graph will be equal to how much of my score. So I'm going to use a scale over here. So I'm going to say my y-axis axis, 1 centimeter equals to 1 unit, and x-axis, 1 centimeter equals to, I'll say assign the camera. So basically I'm going to say this block here will represent one camera. So now I'm going to draw my axis. X-axis, that's my Y, and X-axis. Whenever you draw a graph, it is always important to label your graph as much as possible. So this is going to be my score, and this axis is my camera. So now my first camera I'm going to draw is my hex 11. So I'm going to say assign it a letter H. That's for hex 11, and it has a score of 6.6, so I have to draw my scale here. That's 0. I'll say this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 in total. So hex 11 has a score of 6.6. So I'm going to take my ruler here, go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.6. These smaller divisions here, I'm going to zoom in. That's the maximum. So these smaller divisions here are 0.2. basically you got, that is 1 centimeter, so that's 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, and 1 in total. And hence when I go to mark my 6.6, I'm going to go 6.6 on top, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.2, 4, and 6. This is where my point is going to be, and I draw a straight line from there. Okay, and I said my x-axis 1 centimeter is one camera, so that's where it's going to be. And so that is my bar for my hex 11. Next one I'm going to look at Apollo SX. So I'm going to say that is A. That has a score of 8. It's pretty straightforward. So on my axis, that is 8 over there. That's the point. Draw a straight line and complete the chart. A. Next is Cam XL, which is 6.2 again. So I'm going to mark C, which is Cam XL again, 6.2. So that's my 6 mark. 6.2 will be just one above. So I'm going to start here. Mark it at the bottom, 6.2, as straight as possible. Mark the top. The last one is JAPA C4, so I'm going to mark it over here. That's going to be J. That has a rating of 5, so that's 5. There. So this is what my final diagram will look like. So draw a chart to show the means of how easy it is to use the four cameras. That's my camera, that's the scope, and I'm going to give this whole graph a heading. So how easy it is to use cameras. So that's my 3C solved. So now let's move on to 3D. The table below shows the result of camera test. Complete the table with your mean scores from question 1, how easy it is to use, the order of the cameras using the mean for how long the batteries last, and how easy it is to use. Basically, we got to write down the mean and then order them as first, second, third, and fourth according to the rating that we calculated. That is the mean rating. So what I'm going to do is go back to my first question, wherein I calculated the mean scores for my how easy it is to use. So these are my scores here. So what I'm going to do is write down the scores for the four cameras. Hex 11, 6.6. Hex 11, mean 6.6. Apollo SX is 8. Cam XL is 6.2. And JAPA C4 is 5. Once I have this data, that goes aside. Let's work with our data now. So let's find the order for this mean here. So 7.6, 6.0, 5.5, 6.9. So basically how you have given the order is the highest number gets the first rank, followed by the second highest gets second, and then so on. So the highest number here is obviously 7.6. So I'm going to give it the first order. Second number is 6.9, so that's second. Third number is 6.0, so that's third. And the last one is 5.5, so that is going to be fourth. Next, how easy it is to use. The highest score we got is Apollo SX, which is 8. That's going to be first. Second one after that is 6.6, so that's going to be second. Third is 6.2, so that's third. And finally, JAPA C4 got a score of 5, which is going to be fourth. So this is, that is the question solved.